Hi to all. So in last class we discussed about how to copy files from one directory to another directory and how to move files one directory to another directory and how to move files in same directory from one directory to another directory. So coming to now, so now we are going to discuss about the special topic user management in Linux. Actually, so in Linux there is actually two types of users in Linux. One is root user and one more is normal user, and one more user is super user. I'll tell you about super user later, because super user have some special commands. Super user only performs that commands. So coming to root user, there is only one root user for a Linux system, and this root user can be created by default while installing the Linux, and this root user has total control of the Linux system. So if you forget about the root, like the root user password, so then you'll lose complete access about the complete system, like complete access Linux system. So here the root user only controlling the total Linux system. So here the how the root user controlling or managing means, like this is the like the scenarios, like the managing all the system resources and the manage the file management and manage the user management and the configuration part in the network side and the system configuration, and while installing software installations also. Like for example, I need to install one software in different systems, like different like connected systems, like connected machines, like in 100 machines. So for manually takes more time. For coming to Linux, we can install with only Linux command in different machines, like automatically. So it's reducing time also. So coming to normal user, any other user added by the root, here the root user will be added, this user will become a normal user. So the normal user have only home directory access. So first we'll start with creating the user. So after that we are adding the user. So for that adding user, we need to enter first in the root directory. After that we need to add the user. After that we need to view the user, like based on the ID username. After that we are going to switch user. What's about the super user, how we are going to perform. So let's start with to enter root first, then you'll get some clear picture idea about. So now I'm in the Linux here. Yeah, we'll start now. See here. Yeah, for entering the root, there is a two commands, sudo su or sudo su root. So I'll show you sudo su. Yeah, it will ask for password. So actually it's in I have created already one user, so that's the reason it's asking. Macker is the user I created. I'm coming out of this first. One second. Yeah, I came out of this one. So I am going to execute. I am going to root now. Yeah, now I am entered the root folder. So you are able to see here, right? Root, the folder. This is the root. This is the root user here. So now I am going to add user. So here the command is add user to username. So add user. So like I'm going to create a username as multi. So here ask like some multi, like normal questions. What's the password? So I'm using the same password, like multi, the same read. Again I'm going to enter the full name. It will ask some questions, so the same you can give. The same name or the same password you can give, because sometimes you will forget. That's another issue. If we forget, then again we need to do something. So enter random number. Yes, I want to save. Right. So now we saved the user details, like that detail, the room number we are given now. So let's come to here. Now I'm going to view the user. Okay. So here ID username. What's the ID? What's the username here? We given multi. See, by default for the multi user, they created ID 1004 and the group ID groups. We'll discuss about this one, groups 1004. You are able to see, right? So coming to next, I'm going now, if you want to switch the user, we're able to switch the user, like in the GUI also. I'll show you how it will switch. What's the user we created here? Multi, right? Yeah, I'll show you here. See here, if you have selected switch user, it will take some time actually. So we need to wait for some time. Yeah, for the meanwhile, yeah, here actually for the super user, there is a for every normal user is they are not going to be a super user. So first we are converted that normal user to a super user, then only we are able to access. Yeah, we'll see now. Is it open RC? What we created is a multi, right? I'm going to multi here. The same password I have entered. So here we are able to switch the GUI also. Next super user, right? Understand? It's loading finally. These things handle I don't want. I just click on skip. Because this thing first, right? I created new, right? So maybe that's the reason these things they are asking. So I'm redirecting to terminal. Yeah, here I'm redirecting terminal now. So I'm going to perform this thing. Yeah, I'll show you what is a super user now. One second. Yeah, sorry. For the multi, what we pass the same thing, right? See, we're able to see multi is not in the sudoers file. This incident will be reported. See, are you able to see right now? Because this one is a normal file what we created, but this is not a super file. So now I'm giving access to super file, this one, multi I'm going to. So I'll show you one more thing. So I'm redirecting back to root user. Again, it's taking much time. This is what the actual problem once came, like for switching user, it will take more time. I'll show you now. Is the root user? Yeah. Here is the root user. So I'll show you now how many users are there. First, what we created? We created multi, right? Yeah. It's taking much. Yeah, well, I'm coming back to here. Exit I created. So I'm coming here. Yeah, well, I'll show you the users first. So there is a multi and Sai users is there. So then I'm going to here. Yeah, cat slash users, sorry, etc pss and the current. See, now actually I created four users here. One is Avid and one more is Viking and one more is Maker and one more is Multi. The last one, we are able to see here the details from where it is actually created. Okay, so for every user you need to enter root first, then only you are able to add the user, right? So yeah, Now, to see the if you want to see the pseudovers, like who are the pseudovers, I given access to these things like Viking matter. So I'll show you now how exactly it will work. Sudo su username. Yeah. Sudo su multi. So this one here, this is a multi, not a multi user. So we're going to back here. So again we are performing this thing. Yeah. See, this is a normal user. So I'm going to perform this one. I'll show you how many sudos is there. Sudo nano. This is the command. Etc. Sudoers. It's asking for multi. For password. Yeah, see, now you are able to see, right? Multi is a not the sudoers file. So I am going to convert this one as a sudoer file now. So I am coming exit from the multi now. So now I am here. So I am performing this one. Sudo su. Sorry, it's not coming. Okay, let me type sudo nano etc. Sudoers. See, I told you, right? I given access previous this one Avid as a super user. So the same thing here. I want to give the all access to this. What I am going to use for to multi. Multi. The same thing. I'm just pasting the same thing here. So if you want to click this one, Control X and Y. Yes, it's saved. Wait. Yes, it's saved. Yeah, previous what happened, and now that time we are not able to this one, right? Multi is a not in the sudoers file. This incidence will be reported, right? Now I will show you sudo su multi. See, multi is a sudoer now. Now I am able to access this one is a multi also sudoer file, right? Yeah. That's what we got to know, like how to add user, how is the super user, how to see the users, and how to switch user, and how to based on the ID name. So I hope you got some clear picture idea about this. So if you like my videos, please subscribe. Thanks a lot.